just this one day, Anthony, to expect him to show some interest inside the house instead of the pigeon shed. So by the time that family get here, I want you to be... So by the time that family get here, I want you to be smartened up, with your shoes clean and a smile on your face.
Merry Christmas,
Compo. And try and make yourself pleasant to people. Oh, come on. Try and make yourself pleasant to people. It's not their fault they haven't got feathers and come racing home from...
Happy Christmas, Wally. Christmas, kid.
Christmas.
Well, that's a nice load of language for a Christmas morning.
Let me uncle, Mr. Summer, and he's gone plumb.
So's your language. Hey, is that Christmas present?
Aye.
Oh, I've got the digital watch. You can't see it in the daylight, you see. You can only see it when it's dark.
Forever. I was a Mr. Fortnite last year. It worries me. The Russians don't have it, you know.
Well, there you are, you see. If you look close enough, there's some good in everybody.
There's no Christmas for them. Now, God is the sort of self-employed person they won't tolerate. What is going to happen when they wake up to the fact that every year at Christmas, England is more or less closed for a fortnight?
You think they might?
Well, of course they might.
Well, no, they'd never get in.
Of course, just
on a bank holiday, they'll be stranded. Please write my plans any travelling during a bank holiday.
What time, dinner?
Lunch. Dinner is at night.
Oh, we have two dinners at Christmas, huh?
Well, we haven't got it in the oven yet.
Oh, heck. Look at him, Norby's army man. Look at the way he's bandaging them poor little defenseless sausages. Run that!
Stop. There is nothing to stop you lending a hand, provided you have washed it since you last had one of ferret.
These are for eating, aren't they?
Yes, but not by you. These are savoury snacks for the benefit of any visitors who might pop in.
All right, well, I'm a visitor, and I'm popping.
You did not pop in. You came in dragging your feet like a small tip subsiding.
You should talk about small tips. You have a word with that waiter down at the Chinese chippy. What's it? No. I'm making a cocktail. Anyway, Noddy, who do you think's going to visit us at Christmas?
Well, I can't forecast that exactly. I mean, what do you want, a star above the chimney?
Nobody is going to be visiting us. Nobody. We're going to be stuck here like three muffins, looking at each other.
You can't rely on not having callers at this time of the year. I mean, at this very hour, the world is bung full of people, stuffed to the gills with goodwill, just bursting to inflict it on somebody. Think of it. I mean, all this evening, there's going to be ordinary, decent little families tucked up round their terrace. And then there comes this heart-stopping ringing at the doorbell. And we all know who's going to be on the doorstep, don't we? Some idiot they'd rather do without wearing a big boozy grin.
Nobody's going to be visiting us. The last visitor I had were a bloke from the dashboard looking for a leak.
You know, I can quite understand I'd mistake your place for a public convenience.
It were him from Aslett Street, stupid. You know, married the eldest banknote lass. You think with a choice like that, they'd never let him look for anything, would you? Why don't we open the presents?
We are not opening the presents. No, we'll open them later on, after dinner, lunch, when we're all still seated round the festive board.
Well, I'm festering bored already.
How do you think I feel? I gave up smoking so that I'd live longer. It's at times like this you wonder if you're doing the right thing.
I've got an idea!
What?
No, it doesn't matter.
Come on.
Why don't we open the presents?
Please shut up about the presents. No, we've done the vegetables. Now we'll leave the turkey on a low gas.
Chicken.
Well, whatever it is, we'll leave it on a low gas and we'll go out for an hour. If nobody's going to visit us, we'll go out and visit somebody.
Serve them damn well right. I mean, why should they be enjoying themselves?
Visit who?
Old Edgar. In hospital, lying on his bed of pain on Christmas Day.
You mean we're going to visit hospital on Christmas Day?
We are.
Boy, this is going to be a Christmas to remember. Something to tell my grandchildren about.
Your grandchildren? You've got any grandchildren? You haven't even got any children. To which, on behalf of British genetics, I'd like to offer you your country's deepest appreciation.
I've not read the right bird yet.
How about the one that looked like Mussolini?
Hilda.
That's right, Hilda Mussolini.
Christmas is magic when you're a kid. Grown-ups never get any fun presents.
Well, you could say that here, but I wouldn't say it in front of her from the cleaners. I saw her last week sneaking into mother care.
Oh, it's only fishy, you know, to try and find out what it is we bought him.
I bet it isn't a skateboard.
A skateboard? I bet it was another skateboard. Oh. Never next of it. Don't be ridiculous. I'm not spending that amount on him.
Well, you're on it, Foggy. I'll say that much. I'd have pretended I wasn't buying him one because I was concerned for his safety.
No. They're unbreakable, that kind, you know. Now, if there was a gigantic earthquake, he'd come whistling out of the rubble with scarcely a scratch on his belly.
Do you think I'm a failure?
Only if you judge by surface appearances. Well, for some people it would be enough to recognise that you have a tiny forehead and a low IQ. They wouldn't stop to recognise that underneath you could be showing things like an aptitude for a raggy vest.
Oh, sorry. Would the guardian like for you, the feckless boy, to adopt his leave it to Foggy? Foggy will steer you right. Now, I've taken you down to the hospital not merely to bring a little light into Higgler's life, but to try to raise your very depressed attitude to the festive season. Incarcerated in those wards, and then perhaps you will start to count your own blessings.
Best Christmas I've ever had. To be quite honest, the only four in Finn's business inside.
You're right there, Edgar. It's boring me.
Doesn't mean it, Edgar.
Oh, yes, I do.
Oh, yes, he does. Look at his face.
Listen, Edgar, it's bad enough having to look at you without having to look at his face.
Norman, happy young time.
Remember where you are. Not advisable for anyone who looks like you to get stroppy in here. They're accustomed to cutting out and throwing away better looking bits than you.
Fancy up?
However, that poor bloke in the next ward supposed to be dying. Even he was having a better time than us.
Please.
Thanks for asking. Why did you go to old man then?
just go and see if Sir Noel has dashed off the third act yet. Well, where's he gone to now?
Maybe he's looking at his watch.
Sid, look, there's the band.